guys, is it? Sweet Birmingham, this is your main event of the evening. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event. I said, are you ready? The following contest is for the ICO British kickboxing title and will consist of 5 2-minute rounds. Introducing first, from IMMA Ireland, fighting out of the blue corner, Rachel McElhagger! And her opponent, from Gilmore's Gym, fighting out of the red corner, Maceye!
Here we go, the last contest of the evening, Dale. 5 2-minute rounds. ICO British title. Maceye from Gilmore's, Rachel from MMA Ireland. We've seen Maceye's sister in there already tonight. Fantastic performance.
The Irish do normally come to fight.
Yeah, very tough. Looking very composed, Maceye on the outside. Lovely body kick.
Very purposeful in what she's throwing as well. She's not wasting anything.
Yeah, 5 2-minute rounds as well. It could be that Rachel's just taking a good look at her here in the first round, seeing what she's got.
Her face is reddening up though. She's looking a little flustered.
Right hand over the top there by Maceye.
She might be wanting to have a look at it, but you don't want to get punched in the face while you're doing it.
Paul's breathing and very strong there, and at Gilmore's these days, isn't he? He's a
producer. Very tidy hands as well.
Tempted spin, she's got the range wrong on that one. But yeah, there is a reddening around Rachel's face already. But looks tough enough, resilient enough.
The Irish normally are.
Again, nice level switch there from Rachel, working the body as well as the head. I like that. Maceye looks like she's the stronger of the two. But good resilience from Rachel.
Again, a lot can happen over 5 rounds.
Okay, seconds out, please. Fighters in the centre of the ring. Fighters ready, round two.
Rachel leading with the kick.
Maceye straight down the pipe again though.
I think Maceye just looks a little bit more robust, doesn't she?
Yeah, the contact's just a lot more solid when it lands, hands and feet. And I think I said this before, it's not like she's faster. There's no particular lightning speed there from Maceye. She's just accurate.
Yeah. Very efficient. Right hand twisted the head of Rachel there. The one thing I would say, she's just got to be a little bit mindful of her defense. Obviously, she's not getting much coming back at her in terms of danger, but that left hand is a little low.
But I do think Rachel looks a little fresher in this round. Like she's blown the cobwebs off.
Yeah, I just don't think she's got the power to live with Maceye. That's the problem.
No.
Maceye looks very heavy-handed. Nice kick there. Oh, lovely straight down the pipe.
Backed up with a little short jab too.
Yeah, she's always set for those punches, isn't she? She's not like jumping in on them. She's always got always coming from a good base.
They say she's economical. She's not using any energy she doesn't need to use.
Nice lead leg, lead hook.
You can see the weight behind the kicks and punches when they land.
Just needs to watch that lead hand drop in. Maybe not tonight, but somewhere down the line, she comes up against a fighter that's got a good right hand of their own.
Yeah, and even in a fight like this, underdogs are dangerous.
Yeah.
You know, hurt fighters are dangerous.
Okay, second round, please. Fighters to the center of the ring. Ready to start round three.
Yeah, but I stalled it out. I didn't
even have... Rachel looks like she's up in the pace here in the third round now.
She's turning it into a bit more of a fight.
Yeah, I don't think she's got anything to trouble Maceye with, so maybe she should just look at now outworking her.
Trouble is she's got to get in range to outwork her, and whenever she's in range, Maceye's just too accurate.
Yeah, very, very accurate with the straights. But maybe Rachel needs to turn it into a bit of a dogfight, you know?
That's what I'd be telling her to do. I like a good dogfight.
This is better from Rachel. She's firing straight back, which is good. I just think when Maceye lands that clean shot, Rachel feels it.
But is it that Rachel's found a groove, or is it that Maceye's slowed down a little bit?
A bit of both, maybe. Switching to southpaw there, back to orthodox.
Oh, nice heavy body shot.
Looking to give her a different look. But again, that right hand over the top is something that Maceye needs to watch out for. Now, I don't know if it's enough to win it, but this has definitely been a better round for Rachel, hasn't it?
Yeah, I still don't think she's doing enough to win it, though. Maybe not today, but I think Maceye is open, like you say, to that overhand right. She's just a little too...
Well, again, she's offence-minded, isn't she? She knows she's got a dig on her.
It's like she's looking over the top of her work. She's not settling down looking through her work, so she's a little bit safer. She's kind of looking what's going on, and that's where she's going to get caught with that right hand.
So we're three rounds deep, Dale. You got it three rounds to the good for Maceye?
Yeah, I think so. Although Rachel has pulled back towards the end of that last round, she was finding her groove a little bit.
She's got better and better every round, hasn't she?
Yeah.
Round four.
Think she's happy with where she is in this contest so far. Nice left hook, right hand.
She's getting a bit more coming back at her now, though.
Yeah, I think Rachel's got like a stubbornness in her, hasn't she?
Seen it happen before in this very room, the Irish coming back from what looked like a defeat.
Left up there by Rachel. Not quite set on it though. Ball calling for Maceye to keep her shape. He knows that's where the power's going to come from. Probably Macy's first time into the fourth round though as well. You've got to take that into account, Dale.
True. But Rachel is just trying to turn it into a bit of a fight now. But unfortunately, it means she's walking into a lot.
Ooh, big right hand. It does look like it's a closer and even, a more even contest here in the fourth round, doesn't it?
100%, yeah. I think Rachel start coming back into it at the end of the third, but I don't know if it's enough to win the round.
No, it's that clean concussive shot that that grabs my eye, if I'm honest.
Yeah, the damaging shots, that's where the damage is coming from. Yeah, Rachel's hassling her, making it harder for her, but she's not winning it.
And it's just a different sound when Macy lands, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's like a thud.
A hollow thud.
Okay, seconds out please. Fighters to the center of the ring. We go into the fifth and final round, ladies and gentlemen.
It's the last round of the evening, Dale. British title fight. It looks to us like Macy Wintle is in the ascendancy here. But that's not taking anything away from Rachel, who's been in the fight and got better and better as it's gone along.
Yeah, I think Rachel's motivation at the minute is either going to be, she's not going to win, so the new goal now is go the five rounds. That's one motivation. Or the other is to just throw everything in there and try and stop her in the last round. And I don't think she's made that decision. He says it's the right hand lands.
Yeah. Nice turning side kick. That was the cleanest connect on the turning side kick that we've had.
Was that? No, that was a clean. That was the icing on the cake, I think, that.
And Macy had attempted that twice in the contest already, but didn't get the clean connect. That was a clean connect.
Yep.
And Rachel tried to hide it. She tried to hold it.
Yeah, she felt that.
Back with those round kicks to the bodies now.
Yeah.
And they're calling for the body from the Gilmore's corner. They know that shot's there. Rachel hasn't thrown a shot in anger since that turning side kick landed.
She just covered it up.
Yeah, that really took it out of her.
She's still walking forward. That's the Irish.
Oh, the turning side kick again. That wasn't far off.
That was better defended with the elbows, though. She's a little bit more cautious of him. Macy's looking for that stoppage now. Rachel's gone into survival mode.
Yeah, I think she needs to go back down to the body. I still think that Rachel's feeling the effects of that kick.
But I don't think you've got any quit in her.
Head kick there. Last 10 seconds. And the fighting Irish right there till the final bell. Credit to both girls, but I think there's only one winner there, Dale.
Yep, yep.
Macy Wintle, a worthy British champion from the Gilmore's gym.
Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for both ladies that took part in a cracking main event title match. We've been joined in the ring by Amy Weaver, who's obviously head of AW Kickboxing. To put the show on tonight, and we've also been joined by Andrew Hennessy, who's the president of the International Combat Organization, that's also helped to put the show on. So a big round of applause for both Amy and Andrew. They'll be presenting the winner with the title. Also, ladies and gentlemen, before I announce the winner, something that I'm really proud to be a part of, and I thought I'd let you know that you've been a part of something really special tonight. Amy and Andy have put on the first ever all-female UK kickboxing championship. And you guys have all been a part of that. And I'm sure, looking at the success of tonight, and the girl power that we've all felt, I'm sure, Amy, there's going to be a number two.
100%.
Okay, well. Okay. Now, ladies and gentlemen, our unanimous decision. And your new ICO British kickboxing champion, fighting out of the red corner, Maceye. Do you guys ever lose?
Yeah.
We're trying not to.
I come to the show 2 weeks ago, won every one.
Yeah.
I went to the other one. Okay, Rachel, Maceye, can we get your team in the ring, please? We'll take a nice photo. Both our main eventers here and their team. We've got Andrew, we've got Amy, we've got Maceye, and we've got Rachel, everybody! Well done, girls.
Come around the ring, we've got awards.
Okay, also guys, before you go, if I can just hold your attention for two more minutes, please. Because can we have...